Hey guys, so for today's look, I want to do something fresh and glowy. So that's what we're going to do today. That is actually my favorite looks to do, fresh, glowy skin. So today's look is going to be more focused on the skin and we're going to try to get it nice and glowy and fresh looking. So that's the goal for today. So let's get started. I think I'm just going to put my hair up. I'm gonna start off with the face first today because we're not gonna be doing a lot for the eyes today. So I'm taking this L'Oreal Magic Lumi Primer and I really like this because it gives me a nice glowy finish to the look, and that's what we are trying to do today. So I'm just going to massage this onto my skin. This doesn't really do much for your pores, like for filling in pores and all of that. So if you have larger pores, I would recommend going in with a primer that fills in pores right after this. But my pores are not too big, so I can kind of get away with it. Now for extra hydration, I'm gonna be using the Fursali Rose Gold Elixir. I love this stuff, and I definitely notice a difference whenever I use this. This stuff is so good. It gives you so much hydration and I just find that my makeup just looks really nice and flawless. I do have combination skin, but it doesn't, you know, make me look oily or anything like that. It's just really sinks into the skin and makes your makeup look really nice and glowy, and your skin just looks really hydrated. I'm also going to put some on my lips. So after this, you want to wait maybe like a couple of seconds, like 30 seconds, to let everything just kind of sink into your skin before you move on to foundation. So now for foundation, I'm going to be using the CoverGirl Vitalist Elixir Foundation. This is a really good foundation from the drugstore to give you that nice, flawless, healthy glow to the skin. I'm just going to dot this onto my skin like I do with all my foundations. I do have a pimple right there. And I'm going to take my damp beauty blender and bounce this into the skin. So I'm not looking to cover too much of my skin. I still want my skin to peek through just a little bit. So I'm not too worried about the coverage. Although this foundation does give you a very nice coverage, so you can totally build it up to a full coverage if you want. But I'm going to leave it at just one layer for today. Then you always want to drag it down to your neck. You don't want to have any demarcation lines. Now for my concealer, I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Secret Concealer for Under Eye, and this is in the shade 2.5. I haven't used this concealer in so long, but I have definitely already hit pan. It's really nice and creamy. I've never really been into the cream concealers because they were always kind of dry for me, but this one is super creamy, super full coverage. And when it comes to my concealer, I always want a full coverage concealer because I just love concealer. I cannot do it without concealer. So I'm going to take it right up against the nose. That's just going to slim your nose a little bit. And I'm also going to take it right into the inner corner of my eyes because that's where we tend to get the most darkness. So on my chin, down the bridge of my nose to highlight, and then some on my forehead. A lot of concealer for today. Alright, so now I'm just gonna take my beauty blender, spray it with some MAC Fix Plus or any kind of setting spray that you have. This will just ensure that you get a nice hydrated under eye and that it lasts long because you are spraying a setting spray. Do a little bit of cream contouring. In my opinion, cream contouring actually looks really natural on the skin because it just blends into the skin so beautifully. I'm gonna be using the Sonia Kashuk Rich Bronze Cream Bronzer. I used to use this all the time before. It's a beautiful color, at least for me. I really love the color. I'm gonna be taking it on this Morphe M460 brush. I'm just going to carve out the cheekbones. I don't want to use a bronzer or a contour powder that's too ashy because we're trying to achieve a fresh, glowy skin, something that looks pretty natural. So you want to go with a contour shade that is not too cool, not too ashy, but also not like orange, you know what I mean? So I think this is just the perfect shade. I am just gonna take my Luxie, this is a 504 large angled brush, and I'm going to blend it in. So now we're just gonna go on and set everything. So we're gonna set all the creams that we used on our face so that it stays all day and it doesn't move around, slide around. But I'm gonna be using very little powder because I just want this look to be glowy and not powdery, you know what I mean? I'm just gonna take just a little bit, tap off the excess, and I'm gonna just set underneath the eyes. And then I'm gonna take that same powder and I'm going to just clean up underneath my contour. So. For the eyes today, I'm gonna be taking the Master Palette by Mario. I love this palette. I feel like this is definitely my go-to palette, this one and the Modern Renaissance. You honestly don't need anything else if you have this palette and the Modern Renaissance. Those two are just my top favorite palettes ever. Don't you just hate when you have foundation on your lips? I hate it. Makes me look like I'm dead, so I just took that off. All right, so I'm not gonna be doing too much on my eyes today, just wanna add some definition and then something nice and shimmery on the lid. And I'm gonna take this shade right here, which is called Isabel. I'm just going to be putting this into my crease, just in my upper crease. Just to add definition, you know? And I think I mentioned this in my other video, but I like to just kind of tilt my head back to really see my crease properly. Just gonna take a little bit more. Just go out of here. So I'm just keeping the shadows rounded. Just doing some circular motions to just get this nice and blended all over the crease. Next, I'm going to take a little bit of Muse right here. So I'm just going to pack it here first. Just like move it around in circular motions right here. And I'm not going up to the crease just yet. I could have one palette for the rest of my life, this would be it. This palette is everything. So now that I've kind of packed it on the outer V, I'm going to take that same blending brush that I've been using and I'm going to just blend kind of up into that crease. I'm not touching this outer corner too much because I don't want to take away the darkness, but I just want to blend the edges. I don't want this eye look to go the other way as it. I don't want it to turn into like a smoky eye. I'm trying hard because I love smoky eyes. I feel like I do that a lot. For the lid, I'm going to be mixing Hollywood and Fifth Avenue. I'm just going to take this Anastasia brush, tilt my head back to really see where my lid ends. And then you want to kind of like merge the gold with the purple that we added on the outer edge. Now I'm just gonna take my same blending brush, blend out the edges of that gold, just a tiny bit. Do is I'm gonna just highlight underneath the brow bone as well. I'm gonna be taking the Maybelline Master Chrome Metallic Highlight. This is in Molten Gold. I have used this in my previous tutorial for the first time and now I can't open it. Ugh. This highlighter is freaking beautiful. Like, wow, Maybelline. Add it to the inner corner for that pop. And then what I'm also going to do is take that highlight, add it to the center of my lid. I'm going to curl my lashes. And you want to give your lashes a very nice curl. So hold the curl there for maybe like 30 seconds or so. Okay, maybe like 15 seconds. For my individual lashes, I'm going to be using a mixture of these Ardell individuals and the Red Cherry lashes. I'm going to first put on the Ardell ones, and then if I think I need a little bit more, then I will go with some Red Cherries as well. I'm just going to place it coming from above. Now we're just going to quickly finish off the face. So I'm going to be taking the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit and I'm just going to set the contour. I'm also going to hit the nose with the same powder. Now we're just going to finish out the face with the highlighter. I'm going to spray my brush with some Fix Plus. This is gonna make your highlight just pop. So if you want that really popping highlight, make sure you just spray your brush with some Fix Plus. Fix Plus. Or any kind of setting spray. Some kind of setting spray. So for lips today, I'm going to line them first with MAC Strip Down Lip Pencil. For lips today, I'm going to be using NYX London Matte Liquid Lip. Oh, what I forgot is blush. So I'm going to be taking this Milani blush, and this is in the shade Bellissimo Bronze. And last but not least, I'm going to spray it with MAC Fix Plus. So yeah, that completes this look. I really hope you guys enjoyed. I really like the way this look came out. I love a nice glowy bronzy skin, especially a nice glowy skin. I love it. I hope you guys did as well. If you did, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you here, and I will see you all in the next one.